everybody. This is Pastor Shea, a.k.a. Chaplain G, coming back at you with another word of encouragement for today. So I wanted to bring you this encouragement. And really, like I did yesterday, I want to put the encouragement right up front. Do your best to persevere. That's my encouragement for you for today. I'm going to read to you from the book of Jude. And really, this was a call to the church. They were under a lot of persecution. A lot of stuff was happening as the Christian faith started up in its infancy. And really what this was, it was just the author, Jude, just reminding people, man, there's a reason we're going through this, and it won't last. But remember where we are, remember what time we're in, and remember who we serve. So that's my call to you. That's my word of encouragement. Continue to persevere. But let me read to you from the book of Jude. This is Jude. There's only one chapter in Jude, so it starts in verse 17. It says, "But you must remember, beloved, the predictions of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. They said to you, 'In the last time there will be scoffers, following their own ungodly passions. It is these who cause divisions, worldly people, devoid of the Spirit. But you, beloved, building yourselves up in your most holy faith and praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, waiting for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ that leads to eternal life. And have mercy on those who doubt. Save others by snatching them out of the fire. To others, show mercy with fear, hating even the garment stained by the flesh." So this is saying, understand that in the last times, there's going to be scoffers. There's going to be people that they hate your faith. They hate that you represent Christ. And as I look at the world right now, that is the time we're in. Even going through some of these processes that we're going through, like in the military with the religious exemption stuff. And it's not just in the military. It's a lot of people around the country that are going through this. And the people, they hear your faith, they hear about it, and they scoff. And they say, "You're foolish. You're going to throw away a career. You're going to represent somebody that's invisible? Like, what do you?" And there's all these questions. There's all this scoffing, right? But it says they're following their own ungodly passions. They're not doing what you're doing. So persevere. Keep pressing. Don't worry about them. It's those people who cause divisions. It's those people who are devoid of the Spirit. The worldly. That's all they're concerned about is the here and now. But as we continue to persevere, it's because we're thinking about something else. We're thinking about what happens after we pass on from this life. We're thinking about eternity. So he says, build yourselves up. Pray. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Remember that God loves you so much. Waiting for the mercy of Jesus when he comes to take you back home to eternal life. But, it says, have mercy on the people who doubt. The Bible would make the claim that those people are dead in their sins and trespasses. Like, one thing I know about dead people don't do stuff. They don't have the spirit of life in them. How can we be upset with dead people for not doing alive things? The Bible would say it doesn't make sense. So it says, have mercy on them. But tell them. Tell them about who Jesus is. Tell them why you're persevering. Tell them what continues to give you hope. Keep pressing forward. Man, this is such an encouraging message. It's and the reason it's encouraging is because given our own strength, given our own drive to want to pursue, we won't achieve this verse. We won't achieve what this thing is asking us to do. It's the power of the Spirit of God. It's the power of Christ that lives in us that helps us continue to persevere. So that's why it says, like, remain in the love of God. Like, remain near to Christ. Make sure he's still abiding in you and you're abiding in him. It's because without Christ, we're not going to persevere. But keep going. Keep persevering. Keep pressing forward. Keep loving people. Even when they shame you. Even when they scoff you. Even when they call you foolish. Even when they try to put you out of a job. even when they try to take things away from you that you value, continue to love them. Love them. Hate the stuff that's tainted by sin that's in their lives, but continue to love them. So it's hard. Without Christ, it's impossible. But we could do it. We could persevere. And that's my encouragement for you. Hopefully you receive it as such. Like I said, this is in the book of Jude. You can go back and read it in context. It's a short read. Like I said, it's only one chapter. Go check it out. Please make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Y'all know all that stuff is free to y'all, but it means a lot over here. So appreciate y'all. Appreciate the love y'all giving me so far. I love y'all, man. I really do, honestly. And until next time, grace and peace.